Here we're given a table that represents a function. We want to determine the value of y, which is this missing output here, when the input is positive 1. Then we want to write a function rule for the entire table. So in this case, these values of n would be the inputs into the function. These values are also the domain of the function. And the values in the second column would be the outputs of the function, also called the range of the function. Looking at this first column, we need to be able to recognize that n is increasing by 1 each time. Negative 2 plus 1 does equal negative 1. Negative 1 plus 1 is equal to 0. 0 plus 1 is 1. 1 plus 1 is 2. And 2 plus 1 is 3. Now let's take a look at f of n, or the outputs. We have negative 5, negative 4, negative 3, an unknown value, negative 1, and 0. Well, from negative 5 to negative 4, that's an increase of 1. Negative 4 to negative 3 is also an increase of 1. So if this pattern continued, y would be equal to negative 3 plus 1, which would be equal to negative 2. Let's go ahead and write that down. We think y is equal to negative 2. Let's see if the pattern continues. Negative 2 plus 1 is negative 1, and negative 1 plus 1 is 0. And now we can conclude that y is equal to negative 2. Now we did just finish studying linear equations, and notice that in this table, if we treat this first column as x and the second column as y, notice that the ratio of the change of y to the change of x is constant, which should remind us of a linear equation. So what we'll do is write the equation for this table in slope-intercept form, or y equals mx plus b form. And then once we have the equation in terms of x and y, we'll write the function rule using function notation. Remember that m is the slope of the line, and b is the y-intercept of the line. Again, m is the ratio of the change of y to the change of x. Looking at our table, notice the change in y is positive 1 when the change of x is also positive 1. So our slope would be 1 over 1, which is just 1. And then b, the y-intercept, occurs when x is equal to 0. Looking at this row in the table, notice that when x is 0, the y value, or the output, would be negative 3, which means b is equal to negative 3. So putting these pieces together, the linear equation would be y equals 1 times x, and then since b is negative 3, we'd have minus 3. Or we can just write y equals x minus 3. But remember, our goal was to write the rule using function notation. So we can replace y with f of n. So we'd have f of n equals, and we'll replace x with n. So we have n minus 3. This would be our function rule for the given table. And just to be sure, we could evaluate this function at the given inputs. If the input is negative 2, the output is going to be negative 2 minus 3, which is negative 5. Let's go ahead and just check one more. When n is equal to 2, the input is 2. And notice that 2 minus 3 is equal to negative 1. So our function rule is correct. I hope you found this helpful.